15.
Firing chain armed. T-minus 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, go for main engine start. 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, and liftoff of Space Shuttle Endeavour, expanding the International Space Station while creating a classroom in space.
Houston Endeavour, ready program.
Roger, roll, Endeavour. Houston now controlling the flight of Endeavour. The Space Shuttle begins its journey back into orbit. Endeavour rolling onto the proper alignment, heads down, wings level for the 8.5-minute ride to orbit, taking aim on the International Space Station for docking on Friday. 30 seconds into the flight, the three liquid fuel main engines will soon throttle back to 72% of rated performance in the bucket to reduce the stress on the shuttle as it breaks through the sound barrier. This view from long-range trackers, now from a camera on the external fuel tank, showing the bird's-eye view of Endeavour heading towards space. 54 seconds into the flight, Endeavour already 8 miles downrange, standing by for the throttle-up call from Capcom, Chris Ferguson.
Endeavour, go with throttle-up.
Go with throttle-up.
The throttle-up call acknowledged by Commander Scott Kelly, joined on the flight deck by pilot Charlie Hobaugh, flight engineer Rick Mastracchio and Tracy Caldwell, Dave Williams, Al Drew, and Barbara Morgan seated down on the mid-deck, Morgan racing towards space on the wings of a legacy. 1 minute, 30 seconds into the flight, Endeavour currently traveling almost 2,000 miles an hour, 14 miles in altitude, 15 miles downrange from the Kennedy Space Center. Three good fuel cells, three good auxiliary power units, three good main engines. Endeavour flying straight as an arrow, 1 minute 55 seconds into the flight, standing by for solid rocket booster separation. Booster officer confirms staging a good solid rocket booster separation, guidance now converging. Endeavour's onboard computers commanding the main engine nozzles to gently swivel, aiming Endeavour for a precise keyhole in space for main engine cutoff. 2 minutes, 25 seconds into the flight. The propulsion officer reports the orbital maneuvering system engines have ignited, providing Endeavour with a kick in the pants for the next minute and a half, assisting the shuttle and its crew on its climb to orbit. Endeavour, 40 miles in altitude, 59 miles downrange from the Kennedy Space Center, traveling more than 3,400 miles an hour. Three minutes into the flight, Endeavour 75 miles downrange, traveling almost 4,000 miles an hour, 47 miles in altitude. All of its systems looking good. Endeavour flying on the singular power of its three liquid fuel main engines, draining a half a ton of fuel per second from the shuttle's fuel tank. We're coming up on the point of negative return, where the shuttle will be too far downrange, too high in altitude to return to the launch site in the event of an engine failure. Endeavour currently 135 miles downrange from the Kennedy Space Center, flying true.
Endeavour, negative return.
Negative return.
Passing 4 minutes into the flight, Endeavour more than 60 miles in altitude, 160 miles downrange from the Kennedy Space Center, traveling 5,000 miles an hour. All systems looking very good. The environmental systems officer reports a good flash evaporator system has been activated aboard Endeavour, providing cooling for the avionics until payload bay door opening. 4.5 minutes into the flight, 63 miles in altitude, 200 miles downrange for Endeavour. Coming up on the 5-minute mark into the flight, 3 good main engines, 3 good power-producing fuel cells, 3 good auxiliary power units, Endeavour, clean as a whistle.
Endeavour, press to ATO.
That call from Capcom Chris Ferguson indicating that even in the event of an engine failure, we can make our minimal orbital altitude targets. However, all three main engines continue to function normally. Endeavour currently traveling 8,000 miles an hour, 67 miles in altitude, 300 miles downrange from the Kennedy Space Center.
Endeavour, single engine apps 3.
Single engine apps 3.
The guidance officer here in Mission Control confirming that Endeavour's computers are commanding the main engines to swivel again, enabling the shuttle to roll to a heads-up position above its fuel tank. This will enable Endeavour to gain better communications through the tracking and data relay satellite system heading uphill.
104.
Single engine Zaragoza 104.
Endeavour, press to Miko.
That call indicating that even in the event of an engine failure, we can make normal orbital cutoff targets. Endeavour looking very fine right now. 3 good main engines, 3 good fuel cells, 3 good auxiliary power units. Traveling more than 11,000 miles an hour, 66 miles in altitude, almost 500 miles downrange from the Kennedy Space Center. Seven minutes into the flight, about 90 seconds of powered flight remaining for Endeavour and its crew.
Go for the plus X, go for the pitch.
Okay, single engine plus 104, nominal shutdown, go for the plus X, go for the pitch.
That call indicating for Commander Scott Kelly his plan of attack once Endeavour is off of the fuel tank. 7.5 minutes into the flight, the main engine soon will throttle down to limit the stress on the shuttle and its 7 crew members to that of 3 times the effect of gravity. Endeavour currently traveling more than 4 miles per second. At the time of main engine cutoff, Endeavour will enter its preliminary orbit at a speed of 5 miles per second. Endeavour currently traveling at 15,000 miles an hour, 20 seconds of powered flight remaining, standing by for main engine cutoff, which will be followed a few seconds later by the separation of the external fuel tank. Booster officer confirms main engine cutoff, standing by for external tank separation. External tank separation confirmed. Endeavour now in its preliminary orbit for Barbara Morgan and her crewmates. Class is in session. Commander Scott Kelly now maneuvering Endeavour to the correct orientation so that video and digital stills of the fuel tank can be captured by cameras embedded in the shuttle's umbilical well.